Welcome back. Here's a little scary news around flying. Suspected hack attacks are on the rise. Listen to this. In just April, 30,000 aircraft were impacted by some kind of software hit, spoofing attack, whatever. And in some cases, the planes lost their navigational capabilities. Yikes. But now one company thinks it's got a solution. It's called SandboxAQ, chaired by former Google CEO Eric Schmidt. Their solution is called AQNav. It's the world's first commercial real-time navigation system powered by AI and quantum sensors, which measure changes in the magnetic field of the Earth. Think about how birds fly, and then think about this. It's already being utilized by the U.S. Air Force, Boeing, and Airbus. Jack Hittery, the CEO of SandboxAQ, an AI and quantum technology company spun out of Alphabet. He's been on a few times. You've kept this under, you didn't even tell me. We had dinner and you didn't tell me.
We couldn't tell you, bro.
How did you keep this quiet for 5 years?
Stealth for 5 years. We had to use stealth for 5 years because this is a global impact. This breakthrough that we've had to be able to fly and navigate with no GPS, as you just opened the segment, 30,000 flights just in April alone of this year were impacted with their GPS, lost GPS. GPS is a global system that we all depend on now, but unfortunately, major nation states are now jamming it. Russia is jamming it. China is jamming it. Iran is jamming it.
It's absolutely terrifying.
They're jamming it because they want to control those spaces and they won't let others use the GPS. That means that both civilian aircraft and military aircraft are being impacted.
So you know what doesn't need or use GPS? Birds.
Birds.
And your technology, and don't go all super science on us, Jack, okay? It's people having a cocktail, whatever. This is similar to how birds fly.
That's right. You look at birds. Birds are navigating 5,000, 10,000 kilometers a year to exact spots. They're doing that with a couple of systems, but magnetic field of the Earth is one of the key ones. We at SandboxAQ figured out a way to have sensors, quantum sensors, pull in the magnetic field of the Earth as we're flying. And then in real time, we developed an AI, a breakthrough AI, a quantitative AI. An AI, this is not a large language model. You can't do this with GPT.
It's not ChatGPT. Who is Benjamin Franklin?
Right? That's right. This is a special AI that we created that can look at those signals from the Earth, magnetic field, which is different every square meter of our Earth, Brian. It has a different magnetic field, like a fingerprint, like a signature, just like our fingerprints are unique. It's not jammable because there's no connectivity.
There's nothing to jam.
There's nothing to jam. No satellites, no radio, no cell signals. This is something that is impacted and has allowed us to navigate with no GPS at all.
What I'm hearing from you, and again, I'm not the brightest guy, but is that all the stuff we use now, which we think is so sophisticated, is going to turn into like the anvil, or like the horseshoe.
GPS is more than 50 years old, okay? It's a system that is very easy to jam. With a $400 device that you could buy online, you could jam this entire studio and the whole surrounding neighborhood from no GPS. And so nation states realize this, and they realize they want to control this. That means, and if you look at Europe alone, British Airways, Ryanair, Finnair, and major airlines have had to reroute or cut routes because they lack GPS to get to that destination. Militaries, when Ukraine is trying to fight back with Russia, they don't have GPS to do it because Russia has jammed that GPS. This is both a national infrastructure issue with airlines around the world and a military defense issue.
Are others working on it then? I can't imagine SandboxAQ, or is this like just yours?
Right now, we are the leaders in the space. In stealth, we worked on this, and now as you opened up the segment, we flew with the US Air Force now. More than 40 flights, more than 200 hours, proving this technology. We've also flown on Airbus and other major airlines as well. So this is now a technology here today, ready to go.
What if there's some like sunspot and weird change the magnetic? Well, I'm probably asking a really stupid question, but this
that's
is not
a great
my
question.
Area of expertise.
That, Brian, that's where AI comes in. AI knows the core magnetic field of the Earth and can see anomalies and say, that's an anomaly, let me fly past that.
I'm trying to go back to high school. It's not consistent. The magnetic field changes.
The magnetic field changes over many, many years, right?
And okay, so not instantaneously.
Not instantaneously, boom, boom. That's correct. While you're flying, it is constant.
So we'll have to, your model will adapt.
Exactly, yeah, that's exactly right. And so basically this gives, initially we're focusing on the airspace because of the urgency right now. As you said, 30,000 flights in April alone were impacted, but soon we'll go to naval and we'll go to land-based as well. Right now, if you're trying to navigate your ship, You also will need this.
It's amazing technology. I'm trying to understand it all. I'm not going to profess that I do, but Jack Hittery, SandboxAQ, kudos to you and your team.
Thank you.
Great stuff.